All right. Next, we will explain about the written test of our 350401 alloy pen. So the 14th sub-question of our experimental question. So regarding this question, actually, what we need to do to configure a GLBP between our switch 1 and switch 2, we have such a spanning tree protocol. However, it is important to note that when it comes to GLBP, there are two roles. One is a VG, one is that AVF consists of two roles. So in a moment, in fact, regardless of switch 1 or switch 2, we will all be referred to as AVF. But this question has some requirements. He said we need it. Using this group number is 30 virtual IP address 192.168.1.254. A very common requirement. The main issue is with the group number. Then look at the following words. He said, we need to make switch 1 become RVG. We are priority 130 by default. Each switch has such an AV with such a priority. Actually, they are all 100. We have a higher priority level. Higher priority, then switch 1 will become AVG. Then switch 1 should be AVF1. Switch 2 is AVEFTW. It seems like he didn't consider this question. Such an AVF problem. So there's no need to worry. What is he saying? Let switch 1. If we appear fault occurred and disconnected, then restore again. So how can we ensure that? He can wait for 35 seconds, then get such an AVG roll again. So, classmates, regarding this question. In fact, in the end, the switch needs to become AVG at the same time. We need to consider this issue of preemptive delay. After waiting for 35 seconds to become one of us, seize back every character in our AVG. Do it like this. First, let's do it this way. Let's first look at my pre-configuration. What about each switch? There is such a VLAN 100, such an SVI interface. So we will operate on this VLAN 100 coming from the switch side. Enable configuration mode for interface VLAN 100. We require group number to be 30, virtual IP address 1.254, then GLBP 30 IP address 192.168.1.254. Such a virtual IP address. Then we need to set this priority. When we choose AVG, there are several larger ones, so GLBP 30 priority. Our priority is to reach 130. On the other hand, we also run GLBP on the switch 2. This is interface VLAN 100. Our GLBP also has group 30 IP address 192.168.1.254 GLBP 30. So we are not changing the priority, then the next door is 130. We can just go with the default settings. On our end, 100 is fine by default. Now let's take a look at do show GLBP. What you need to pay attention to is, so for our GLBP, actually, our discussion is about seizing the upper hand. So we are closed by default. So in a moment, to enable the switch. After we hang up, then switch 2 becomes the new AVG for our GLBP. So we need to turn on our switch 1. There is also preemption for switch 2. Regarding switch 2, GLBP default needs to be disabled. Switch 2 should be able to discover our switch. For example, of course, we haven't done any detection here yet. Switch 2 in reality. Whether we proceed with this preemptive move or not, it doesn't really matter. Is the switch mainly correct? Because the question only requires us to focus on the switch. So do it this way. So now the switch 1 must be AVG. No problem. We are active. As for switch 2, definitely stand by. So we need to set it up first. Preemption delay, GLBP 30. We need switch 1. If we hang up and come back, if you want to seize our AVG, we are going to start seizing. Definitely need to seize the opportunity. However, when preemption is enabled, we said we can't grab it immediately. We need to wait for a preemption delay. So delay, set to minimum, wait for 35 seconds. But what about this side? It is, so we just need to give it a preemption. Delay of 35 seconds, wait for 35 seconds. We are dazzled and seeing things crookedly. 35 seconds. So enable preemption, and after waiting for 35 seconds, that's why we would see such an AVG roll. Looking at this configuration, our AVG here has preemption enabled. We have taken the lead, and if at least need to wait after 35 seconds, that's why we would go to see such an AVG role. So this question is done. Switch 1 is the AVG, switch 2 is standby. Moreover, if switch 1 goes down and comes back up again, we have a 35 second preemption delay. Done, the group number is also correct, so we have successfully completed the configuration for this question. Configuration completed successfully. Remember to save the configuration. Save configuration, end W2. Of course, you can test it, such as PC1, let's ping 192.168.1.254. See if it can be pinged through, added a dot ping 192.168.1.254. As long as it can be pinged successfully, there is no issue. Congratulations on finishing. Save the configuration after completion. We can move on to the next question now. So if you want to learn more about this, information about CCIE certification, welcome to contact our Wolf Lab. So let's move on to the next question. Goodbye. Goodbye.